Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Monster Train here on the channel. Thank you, everybody out there who's been enjoying the Monster Train series as much as I have been playing it. Today, we're going to be doing something a little bit differently. I'm going to show off a feature that you probably have not seen yet anywhere on the internet ever. We're going to be doing a daily run today, and the daily runs, much like Isaac, they have their own parameters, they have their own rules, etc. I went to the wrong part of the screen. Just ignore that. But yeah, I'm going to do today's daily challenge. It's found under multiplayer, not single player, FYI. Let's see what today's daily challenge is. It is going to be, let's see, Hellhorn and Umbra. We got duality, double stacks on all status effects. Okay, that's good, I suppose. Brawl friendly units and enemy units get plus 5 attack, plus 10 HP. Your pyre gets plus 10 attack. Okay, moth magic. When a damage spell hits an enemy, hits a unit, ascend it. Weird. Okay, let's see how my friends did. If any of them did it. No? Okay, good. I've got some great friends here. All right, let's get it going. Start off with Tiresome Climb, Mind Collapse, and Welder Helper. Mind Collapse is not that's a card that you have not seen me use yet in Monster Train. Essentially, it's good if you can get like a 2-cost or a 1-cost kill with that. Anything above 2 is not really, it's kind of not worth it. And Tiresome Climb is also really good as well. Applying Daze 4 is pretty nice. There's our mutators there, and you can see where everybody went off the rails. And you can also see how many people are actually playing it right now, so that's neat. Go check out Herzal's Horde. We have Sketches of Salvation or Traitor's Quill. Whenever you start a round, it will summon 4 random units on our deck to the middle floor. Now, you may think that that's great, but you can't control where those get summoned and also where, like, the position. So I'm not going to do that. I suppose we can just go for the Traitor's Quill for now. Apparently, people can also emote in this mode, so that's fun. And, we'll start out with Multi-Strike. Or do we want to go Slay? You know what? Let's go with Multi-Strike first, and then we'll go Slay. Here we go. I don't actually know if there's a way that you can mute that stuff. Of course, I'm going to start. I mean, this is a competition, so obviously we're going to be going for as many points as possible. Okay, so we don't have any. We have no tanks right now. I mean, well we kind of do. Put you there. And we'll get a morsel out. And that's going to give us Ember on the next turn. And let's go ahead and put a Train Steward up here just so we have something there. I'm also going to turn down the volume because I feel like it was coming in way too loud. Sorry about that. So 11 HP on the Collector. Good lord, there's nothing we can do about that. Well, I mean, we could kill it with the Mind Collapse. We might as well do that. Okay, then we have 6 damage at our disposal here. We're going to be able to get the kill there. We cannot get the kill there unless we were to do this. Even then, that's still not enough. 3 damage. It's dealing 3 damage or 2 damage. Doesn't really matter. Mind Collapse there. So we're going to... So what that did, if you're wondering why that ascended this unit, was because remember we have the mutator of the Moth Magic. So anytime that we land an offensive ability, offensive magic ability, I think that works just for me. It doesn't work vice versa. Then the unit that we hit with a spell is going to be ascended and taken to the next floor. Okay, so we'll get the Train Steward down. We'll also get the Welder Helper here. Adds 30 armor. Man, that's actually, like, crazy good. Let's add 30 armor here just to keep it alive. We don't have to worry about the healer, obviously, and it's dead. We don't have to worry about the healer because the healers literally have no attack value, so there's no reason for us to even care about that. Perfect. Perfect first round. Very nicely done. Okay, Molting Imp, impressive, and then Hidden Passage. We could use that for Ascension. I don't think we need to do that. Honestly, I'm gonna stick to my guns here. I'm not going to be intimidated by the fact that this is a daily. It's a multiplayer challenge. We have Space Prism, making of a morsel, or Packed Morsels, where you consume the morsels. Totally, we get 3 uncommon or rare. Space Prism is really good because that allows you to customize your floor a little bit more. And then, of course, we can also just go for add a morsel minor to our hand, which is the one that gives you lifesteal, I believe. Or maybe not. Eater gains 5/5. Okay, well, I'm gonna go for Space Prism here. I think that one's a little bit better. And then, of course, we gotta go for my boy. Consumer of crowns. We're going imps. That's what we're doing. Get on over there. We're going to go straight to the right track. And let's get our banner. Resolve and we gain 10 armor. This one, although the Railbeater comes with 50 armor out of the gate. And also pushes units backwards. Yeah, you know what? Let's go for the Railbeater. Sure. Multi-strike, you know exactly who that's going on. If we can get the Consumer of Crowns to... If we can get him out there, man, that's going to be all she wrote for this daily. Plus 10 damage. We might as well put that on somebody, put it on the Railbeater. Because he is a little bit beefy. And here we go. Again, there's no doubt about it. If we want to go for a top spot, we've got to go for every single challenge. Okay, got to be careful of the spike. The spiky boy. Now, we can set up the Railbeater to go first. And he's going to knock back the Disciple Protector. And then our Hornbreaker Prince can clean up on the Conduit Redirector. Let's also get the Imp out there to add a little bit of extra armor. Yeah. Now, obviously, I could have ascended there with Fireball, but I chose not to. Wait, the Hornbreaker... How did the Hornbreaker Prince die? Did he get yeeted by... Oh, he's got multi-strike. Okay, and then he hit the double spike. He hit the spikes three times. Yeah, okay. I got it. Well, that's unfortunate. Gonna go for the increased capacity down here. This is a terrible draw for us. Go for a Shade Splitter, and give him the damage shield here. And I think, honestly, I'm not sure if this works on the Collector for our Pyre, but let's just see. Oh, yeah. We got it down. Look at that. All right. Well, that worked well. We don't want to take any Pyre damage at all. We definitely want to get this Welder Helper down because, obviously, again, we're going to try to get the Consumer of Crowns out, although we did lose the bottom imp. Okay, so we want... Let's get you in front. No. Yes, let's get you in front. And then we're going to put a Train Steward in front of that. No, behind the... okay, we got it. All right, then we're gonna get a morsel, or this one's dead no matter what. A morsel doesn't really help, except a morsel does tank one shot. So let's go for that. That would give us an extra ember on the next floor. Although we have nothing to eat it, so that's fine. Yeah. So we'll put the morsel in front here, just to tank one shot. You see there, it increases the damage that we get. The flip flopping of the armor of the knockback and stuff is kind of wonky, but so we can straight up just kill this one, but then we have nothing else to add here, so we should take out this Disciple Protector. I could also ascend him. No, we should take it out without inflicting any damage upon us. And we absolutely do not want to ascend him, although I don't think that we can ascend him anyway. And then we have to hope that our next floor can handle this guy. Not enough. It's going to bring him down to 60... 67. No, 57. I could use... 2-8. No, I wouldn't be able to. I wouldn't be able to kill this off. And even if I could, I wouldn't be able to put anything there. We could do a morsel, but yeah, I don't know if this is. I'm not sure if this is going to make him ascend up. So we're just gonna have to take this. We'll just have to take the lumps. Not the greatest. I think the knockback mob is actually working against us a little bit. So yeah, we lost basically all the points. So that one hurt quite a bit. And again, we're going with imps. So. Space Prism again, Prismal Dust, or the Immortal Trade. Definitely going to go Immortal Trade here. All right, so we can go. There's two ways we can go about this. We could go for a duplicate on the Consumer of Crowns or an Imp and get an Umbral unit, or we could heal up our Pyre and get an artifact. I think that duplicating an Imp is probably the smartest thing that we could do. We have Crucible Warden as well as the Morsel Master. Got to go for the Warden. Wardens are just so good. Now, the big question is, do we clone the Consumer of Crowns to double our chances of getting one out, or do we put out the Molten Imp? The Molting Imp. We have no way of healing. I think you just gotta go all in and hope that we can get him out there. Okay, we get a rare Awoken draft pick, Melting Remnant draft pick, or Stygian Guard draft pick. Let's go for Awoken. This gives us an emergency heal that doesn't cost anything. I think you gotta go for the Wildwood. An AoE full heal. You never know how much that's going to help us out. You could argue regen and spikes, but we're not looking to flood our... We're trying not to flood our deck. It's gonna be Daedalus. We have the Explosive Sigil, so we know that that's going to be an extinguish. Deals one damage to all enemies in front of the unit that dies. Man, that 14 damage, though. That's rough, man. Man, I kind of don't even... You don't even want to really put anyone out there right now. Because we have no beef. That's the problem, is that we have no beef here. Although, again, the Rail Beater does have armor, but he's going to lose basically all of it. He's going to take 42 damage just from the attacks. Not even like counting the extinguished hits. This may be a mistake, but it's my mistake to make. And I'm going to just simply... I don't want to put nothing down. Let's put the Rail Beater up top. Let's get him fed some morsels just so we've got something going on. He gets damage shield. That's fine. And you know what? Let's put the Hornbreaker Prince up here as well, just so we have something going on. Okay, Daedalus puts the bomb up top. I really would prefer the damage shield to not get taken up, but... is what it is. So now they're doing 36 damage. Man, that's so much damage. We could go Crucible Warden, Welder Helper, and then a Morsel. Okay. I could try to put Immortal Trade out there, but that's going to put Ember Drain 4 on us, which is just insane. Okay, I can put space here. Let's put another Welder Helper so we have another Imp down. And a Morsel. Good, 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 good. So the Excavator is good because that's going to give him Lifesteal 2. Okay, and then we can ascend this one to get yeeted by our top floor. Okay, and then... I mean, the train steward doesn't matter, but I'm gonna put him there, not for any purpose other than just to get him out of the deck. Okay, mind collapse. We have another imp coming our way here. With the imp, let's see, that deals 5 damage. We would need 6 damage total, which means that we can play one imp and then mind collapse to get the destruction on the bomb. This gives us another imp down, which allows us to get the Consumer of Crowns. We just got to pull them now. Okay, do we go for the full heal here? I think everyone's good. This one's actually gonna gain life, so that's good. And we can deal 6 damage. Again, I'm doing this just to burn the deck right now. So we still haven't pulled him yet. Get some armor here. I don't know what we do about this about the bomb, though. I cannot ascend it because... Can you as... You know what? Let's see. We do... Oh, yeah. Watch this. So she shouldn't be able to attack anything. Oh, but we're going to lose our Gorger, though. Our Warden, I mean. Oh, my goodness. Well, Daedalus will not be getting past us today. So that's the benefit of having three imps down. Good. So we didn't take any... we took fire damage? Was that from thorns, maybe? Okay, so we have Shroud, Mitosis, Kindle, or Forever Consumed. I'm gonna go with Kindle here, just because if we need the emergency ember to get the consumer out, we can get it. And I think we gotta go more. We have to get the Morsel Maker into Crucible Warden combo is just so good. But so is the. I mean, if you can get the Allied Construct out with the Morsel Maker, that's perfect. But the Allied Construct also costs too much. I'm gonna go with the Morsel Maker. Doesn't matter. And I think for this, we want to go Ember here. Okay. Definitely want to get some... we don't have any spells that really matter all that much. It's mostly about units here. Heal of the Pyre, for sure. Let's cut a couple cards here. We're really not using torches, like, at all. Get a damage shield plus 4, man. Who do we give that to? We could give it to the Crucible Warden. Or the Rail Beater, which would give him a ton of armor. Let's put it on the rail. Well, let's give it to the Warden, because that allows us to give him enough time to be kind of like, you know, Hulk up. Do we really want to spend... I mean, it's only 5 damage and 10... No, let's roll it. Okay, we get multi-strike again. Multi-strike's great, especially if we get lifesteal on the Crucible Warden. Yeah, I think you gotta go multi-strike too here. And plus 10 damage. Not really gonna be that useful. Plus 14 rage. Oh my goodness. That's a lot of damage, dude. Sure, put it on the Rail Beater. Why not? The best defense is a good offense. And let's save this other gold here. Multi-strike 4. I think, honestly, I think that going for a little bit more HP is probably smarter here. So multi-strike 4, while it is hilarious, we don't really have anything that can buff his damage right now. So I think that going for the Wrathful is better. Okay. Oh man, spikes are rough, but since this is a daily challenge, I mean, we gotta go for the gusto. Gotta make the big time plays. Yeah, so I think we can set up something like this. Well, let's see what morsel we get first. Okay, that gives us life. So let's go. This is gonna look a little sketch, not gonna lie. Let's hold off on the steward because we don't know where we may wanna have that capacity free. Okay, collector's up there. Let's go for, you know what, let's give me the top 4. Oh yeah, Trader's Quill. I was like, what the heck just happened? Okay, we deal 12 damage, we can gain 2 gold. Let's go do that, or 2 ember. Let's do that just so we don't have to worry about 8 spikes on our champion. Okay, he's still gonna suffer 3 HP damage, which is kind of horrible. Let's get you in front to take some of the damage, and then we'll set up the Crucible Warden up top. Okay, there's our Morsel Maker combo. Very nice. Okay, top floor is set. Now, we got to worry about our champion here. And I also don't want this imp to die. How are we going to do this? This imp is going to die on the marksman, so we need to ascend the marksman. Or not? Question mark? How about we just do that? Not ideal. We're going to take some fire damage here. A lot of fire damage. Actually, that was totally just not worth it. All right, well... I think we got to go full heal here, just to keep everyone somewhat upright. We want to make sure that the imp stays alive. So, 2-1. It's not enough capacity to throw down the consumer. Yeah, it can only go down here. And there's no reason for us to use Kindle right now. So I'm just gonna put the molting imp here. And the rail beater we can put down here. No, we can't. We can't use the rail beater if we want to get the consumer down. So let's ascend you instead. Get you out of here. We're going to lose the train warden, but that's okay. Train steward, I mean. Not train warden. And we're still waiting for the consumer. Give him as much armor as possible, boys. Got a morsel. We're going to lose this imp up here unless we do something. Do that. There we go. Imp stays alive. Can't do anything for the morsel. So we got to hope that we top deck the consumer of crowns. Otherwise, we're in trouble. And we did not get him. Oh, boy. Well, that's unfortunate. Get a Shade Splitter and get a Morsel out just so we can have some tanky stuff going on. We can ascend one of them up top, and that would take care of some capacity space up there. So, I think we use Unleash the Wildwood. We gotta burn all this. And, unfortunately, we gotta hope we draw the other one and we get a torch. So, or no, even if we get a torch, we can't do anything. Well, it's over anyway, but... Was the fire damage worth it? I don't know. It probably wasn't in the grand scheme of things here. I don't know what rank I'm in, but probably not very high. You can't lose 50% of your trial bonus there. When you summon your first morsel unit, each turn, draw one. That sounds good, but it's actually not. It's my imp in a box. Sure. At this point, why not? And then we have Excavation Eruption, Feast, or Cave-In. Feast is really good. I really like Feast. Excavation Eruption is very good, but not for this deck. I think you gotta go Feast here. Okay, we have to heal. I mean, that's just bottom line. If we want to go any further than this, we've got to. All right, let's burn some more cards. I mean, I want to keep Torch around at least a little bit because it is nice to have that targeted ascend. really actually don't see that many good options here. The train stewards have been kind of important. Yeah, I think we only burn one. We're not really using mind collapse. I'm going to get rid of one of the mind collapses. HP here. We could start beefing up our imps a little bit. Just to make sure that they stay alive long enough for the consumer of crowns. Multi-strike. It's not really worth anything. I mean, we could put it on a train steward, I guess, but you never know where that 90 gold is going to be handy. A damage shield on one of the imps. Again, I think that's probably a wise move. Keeping the imps alive. All right. This is going to be sketchy. Definitely sketchy. And with 15 armor on top of the mutator, where everyone else also gets 10 HP, that's going to be so hard to beat. But we gotta do it. We got to make up our score somehow. This is going to be rough. Now remember, on this floor, the enemies, the silent marksmen, always start out with stealth. So they get essentially stealth for the next two turns, which is unfortunate. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the Crucible Warden here. Morsel Maker. And I'm going to put the Welder Helper here as well. The Champion, you can go up here. Okay, we did not top deck Feast, unfortunately. Let's go for down here. We'll use Imp in a Box. Oh, Pyre Chomper is such a huge top deck here. And let's get the Fledgling Imp out as well. Gonna put him in front. And let's get our boys in there. Oh, yes, my friends. Maybe this is the start of the comeback. They're going to take a lot of damage down there, I'm not going to lie. We could give him a mortal trade, sure. Give him lifesteal. It's going to ember burn us to all heck, but you know what? Sometimes you got to do what you got to do. We're going to get two kills here. Not enough for another one, unfortunately. Oh, no, there we go. Because it got pushed into the pyre, although the pyre is going to take damage. Keep forgetting about that ascend. Again, we can't do anything. That stealth too is terrible because of the double stack daily part. Feast now. Our pyre is going to take a lot of damage, dude. We don't have enough damage up top. Well, we're not going to get number one. I think that's safe to say. It has 16 stealth. Are you kidding me? 16 stealth. And both of our consumer crowns are dead. Yeah, never mind. This one is super over. Wow, 16 stealth. That is something that I was not expecting. That is actually... Could I have used a spell to ascend one of the consumer crowns now that I think about it? No, I had no offensive spells. Well, we get the kill. Somehow. Oh yeah! That's right, because he has the damage shield. And then lifesteal as well. Okay, so we're not dead. Again, we lost 50% of our score. That's just canceling out all of our trials, man. Apply 40 armor for 5 damage. That's pretty good. But our deck is already pretty bloated. I mean, we have our win condition, essentially. Void Binding is real good, but the Ember Drain is just crushing. Ember Forge gives us plus 2 Ember per turn, but it costs 4 capacity. Or the Crucible Extension. Go all in. I mean, we got a heal. I don't normally take all this much damage on my Ember, but or on my Pyre. Oh, there's Ziggy. Ziggy's playing now, apparently. All right, this is still a little bit sketch here. Yeah, we can remove the consume. Honestly, putting it on Space Prism is pretty good. Permafrost. I mean, we could use it on Feast, but we could also use it on Immortal Trade or Unleash the Wildwood. Like when we really need it. I like that idea. If we just like really, really need it, and then lowering the cost of Tiresome Climb would also be nice. All right. It's everyone's favorite. And by everyone, I mean no one's. It's my imp in a box. This is gonna seem suicidal, and it may very well be, but I'm gonna put lifesteal on the champion. 6 lifesteal, dude. Okay, never mind, he's dead. you gotta love it. Gotta love it. I'm sure. We're just getting all kinds of baddie with it now. Why not? We've got our consumer up there. He's ready to purchase some fine products. I think you got to use Unleash the Wildwood now. Get him back up to full. Let's just add capacity up here. Why not? This daily has gotten a little out of control. I mean, I don't know if this is going to... No, he's going to die. Yeah, even if I put a Mortal Trade on him, he doesn't act first, and he's going to get hit for 42. And this is where our daily ends, unfortunately. Well, it was a solid effort. It wasn't my best. I think that going for the all-in on the Consumer of Crowns really was not wise. But it was not a bad, like, where everything turned was definitely taking too much damage from the Ascension and like using the spells on stuff. Yeah, so what place did we actually get in today's daily here before we wrap this one up? We finished 531. Not great. Not great. So anyway, I'm going to do it. Anyway, I wanted to show the daily challenges for those of you who have been interested in seeing that. And you can expect what to expect now that you've seen it. It's fun. Monster Train is excellent. I'm glad that everyone's enjoying the game. I'm glad that everyone has been enjoying the series here on YouTube. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite mutator is thus far in the game. How many custom challenges have you made for yourself or your friends? Again, post them in the comments down below. Make sure you leave a like on this video as well if you want to see more Monster Train content here on the channel. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.